Yo, I was not prepared. I was not prepared for any new Juice WRLD before his album. And to be honest, I'm not even prepared for the album. But we got a new track from Juice WRLD post-death. Roll it. Welcome back to the channel, everybody. Channel's name is The Third Ernest. I'm Ernest Adiano III. Y'all guys are The Third Family. If you're new here and you're not subscribed and you like what you see, consider becoming part of the family, clicking the subscribe button bottom right-hand corner. Now, real quick, I'd like to give a shout out to the sponsor of this video. Nah, I'm just kidding. It's not a sponsor, but yeah, my boy who's been supporting the channel and been sending me merch and his company has been growing, Envision. He makes like streetwear apparel, and this is from his most recent, like one of his most recent drops. If you're someone who's into streetwear or someone who's into unique clothing, like it's not that it's not perfect clothing, it just has its imperfections because he literally hand screens every single shirt. And for me, that shit's tight because like the piece that I'm wearing is the only piece that's like it. Somebody else's piece might have some minor imperfections somewhere in there, but that's what makes each individual piece unique. And when I say imperfection, I don't mean like the shit is like whack, because it's definitely not. It's good quality. This right here is stitched in. The back is screen printed. I forget what it says right there, but it says something like any man who tries to become a god ends up finding the devil or something along those lines. It's like a dope ass quote like that. We've literally been coming up like in our individual lanes at the same time, and he's been supporting since like before the channel had 10,000 subscribers. So again, if you're someone who's into streetwear, you're someone who's into like unique one-off pieces or limited run pieces, give this dude a follow. I'll drop the link for the website for purchases down below, and I think it links to his IG as well. But here we have, I think, Juice WRLD's first single on his posthumous album, and his Life's a Mess featuring, is it Halsey? I always fuck her name up. And I'm always nervous whenever it comes to like posthumous records or posthumous albums, because it can easily seem like a money grab. I said this with Mac Miller's album, like the album is perfect exactly as is. The album was literally perfection as it was for the way Mac would have wanted us to hear it. And that's a complete 180 from the way that they handled XXXTentacion's like posthumous albums. Like they're awful. Like, I hate that they did that to his legacy. You can tell that they were money grabs. You can tell that the album wasn't finished, so they just came in and threw like A-list names on it. And I don't want that to be the way Juice WRLD's album is, because he is like a once in a generation artist. And it's bittersweet that people are realizing it now, because they're like, damn, we should have given him a chance while he was alive. He's basically like any other artist post-death, like Basquiat, or anybody who struggled whenever they were alive and then blew up into stardom and their work's going for millions and millions of dollars after their death. That's basically Juice WRLD's path. But that's really all that I gotta say, man. I mean, I'm excited to check it out for sure, but I also have my hesitation because it's like a 50-50 shot with the way that they handle these things after the artist has died. So let's just go ahead and get on into it. Follow your boy on Instagram and on Twitter at The Third Ernest, just like the channel. Links are down in the description below. And we got Juice WRLD, Life's a Mess, official visualizer. So I'm assuming this is kind of like a music video, but not really. Let's get it. Have you ever fallen head over heels for somebody? Juice WRLD's like signature sound, I feel like, is like that very airy vocals. Like, he doesn't really rap, like just straight up rap. A lot of what he's known for is the way that he sings, and is very melancholic and it's airy. Like, he's got a lot of nasal, but that plucking, I don't know what that instrument is. It's not a harp. I feel like it's a harp, but it's not a harp. But that sound is like classic Juice WRLD. Have you ever fallen head over heels for somebody? Not just somebody. No, no. Have you ever fallen head over heels for somebody that made promises to give you the world? I really hope they held you down. I really hope it was no lying, cause when heart breaks it feel like the world's gone. But if the love's right. Yo, his pain and the emotion in his lyrics is something that a lot of people can relate to. Why the hell do I have a sock on the desk? It's like, I really hope that the person that promised you the world gave you that. I hope they held down their end of the bargain, because I know the pain whenever they don't. A lot of people can relate to that. Most people who go through like relationships where they have their traditional arc, where it's like, it starts off the happiest, and then it sort of like slowly fizzles out, like the honeymoon phase is over, and then you start to you know, just y'all start to grow apart. That seems like it's just as, if not more painful than just having your heart broken by the person all at one instance. Like you found out that they were cheating, so your heart's broken because they promised you the world, they promised you all of this, and then they ended up giving it to somebody else. But it's just as heartbreaking feeling that love fade over time. And like you wanna grasp at it, you wanna like make it work, but for some reason, whatever you do, it's just not working. And you know the demise is coming, but you still wanna hold on down to the very end. Yo, that's painful. And I'm assuming this dude in the video is gonna make a mural of Juice WRLD, which is fire because I love seeing muralists like go to work.
I really hope they held you down. I really hope it was no lying, cause my heart breaks and feel like the world's gone. But if the love's real, you feel your soul roar like a lion, and you finally let bygones be bygones. Don't throw in the towel, I know it feels like you're the only one trying. You just gotta learn to live and love on.
Yo, see, like, his lyricism, it's at a completely different level. Like, Juice WRLD, he was just in a class all on his own. Like, there's nobody in his generation that's talking about this kind of pain. There's nobody talking about, like, yes, you've been hurt before, and yes, it feels like you're the only one trying, but don't give up because love is worth fighting for. Like, there's nobody else in his, at least that I can think of, especially, like, in the subgenres of pain rap or emo rap or you know, heartbreak rap or whatever the hell you want to call it. There's nobody that has that like silver lining within their lyrics. Like, yes, that everything sucks. Yes, it feels like you're the only one that's trying. Yes, it feels like you want to throw the towel in, but don't give up. Like, no one else has that. The dude just brings out a whole nother level of emotion from within you, and it catches most people off guard because most people write him off as mumble rapper. Most people write him off as Gen Z rapper or whatever the hell. And there's not a lot of substance in those raps, but when they finally hear and give him a listen, it's like mind blowing, and you feel it deep down.
Someone just gotta look and see. I'm screaming out, Lord, help me. I've been lonely. That's when you reset me. Think you set me free. Sometimes life's a mess.
Oh, that beat drop though. But the lyrics right before, he said, you accept me and that set me free. Like, I come with my burdens, but you still accept. I think that was the lyric, unless I heard it incorrect, but that's what it feels like to fall for someone who you know is that person, who you know is your best friend, or who you know you're ultra compatible with, who you can be completely vulnerable to. Like, they accept you for who you are. Shit's tight. There's a fly on my screen, and I really want to swat at it, but I'm not trying to break this $4,500 computer if I miss. Foo! Missed, but didn't hit the computer though. Go back to that line right before that drop though.
Help me, I've been lonely.
Right here.
That's when you reset me, think you set me free. Sometimes life's a mess. I get high when I'm upset. I remember when me and love did click. Searching for something real, then I found it. Sometimes.
Chorus is fire. I get high when I'm upset. J. Cole said it in KOD. Like, I know that prescription drugs and depression don't blend.
I know you say it helps and no, I'm not trying to offend. But I know depression and drug addiction don't blend. Reality distorts and then you get lost in the wind. And I done seen the combo take niggas off the deep end.
So when you get high when you're upset, and if you're always upset all the time, you're gonna end up becoming addicted to that high feeling. And that was eventually the demise of Juice WRLD. So it's like a painful lyric to hear. Then he follows it up with, I remember when me and love ain't click. I was looking for something real until I found it. That's when everything kind of fell into place. Shit is fire, son. I can't wait for the new album.
But it's better now. Through the trials and tribulations, I felt my way out. Feel all of the good and bad vibrations. All around us. They surround us. Was a lost cause. Was some lost love. It ain't my fault. Pain chose us.
Damn, the highlights on that fist are fire. Do you even realize? You don't realize unless you're an artist or unless you draw or paint portraits or what have you. You don't realize how hard it is to draw hands. Extremely difficult for people to visualize and draw hands, especially just from memory, the way he's doing it. Yeah, literally has nothing to do with the song. So let's go back and listen again because I was just distracted by the hands.
Through the trials and tribulations, I found my way out. Feel all of the good and bad vibrations. All around us. They surround us. Was
a lost cause.
Some lost love.
It ain't my fault.
Pain chose us.
Then I found one.
My whole world turned upside down.
But for the better,
I belong with.
I felt my whole world turned upside down. But for the better. The world turned upside down. If y'all haven't seen the Hamilton shit, I don't know what you're waiting for. That song is fire. But just the way that he used that line, like my world was flipped upside down. Normally that's a bad thing. Normally like you're caught off guard with some tragic news and your world flips. But his life was so depressed and so in the negative until he found love and it flipped in the other direction. That's fire. He said was a lost cause with some lost loves. It's not my fault that pain chose us. Yo, that's a bar.
But for the better,
I belong with the one put on this earth for me. Everybody has their someone, just gotta look and see. I scream out, Lord, help me, I've been lonely. That's when you accept me, then you set me free.
Sometimes.
Do you just hear like the optimism within his lyrics? Like, yes, it's pain emo rap. Like that's the subgenre that he fits in. I keep saying it because that's where he goes. But what made him so different is that his lyrics are very optimistic. They always see the silver lining within any situation. And that's what we're getting right here within this song. And by the way, before I pause it, it completely clicked in my mind that we have this muralist painting because life's a mess and making murals is obviously very messy. Look at the scene right here. Look at just the screenshot. Like we got all this paint on the walls. The buckets are dripping. His clothes are dirty. Painting is extremely messy and it's symbolic of life because you got to go through the mess. You got to go through the trial and error when it comes to painting. You got to go through the process. And that's the way life is. Life's a mess until you find the one and then it ends up life is beautiful, you know? It's fire. But yo, my favorite line, you accept me and you set me free. That's fucking tight.
That's when you accept me, then you set me free. Sometimes life's a mess. I get high when I'm upset. I remember when me and love being crazy. Searching for some real, then I found it. Sometimes life's a mess. Yeah, I get high when I'm upset. I remember when me and love being crazy. Looking for some real, then I found it.
Is that her? I don't know Juice WRLD's like personal relationships. I don't know if it's literally Halsey. I don't know if that's her or is she just on the single to provide that female accompaniment to like symbolize him finding the one. But either way, man, I'm impressed as fuck with this dude who's painting. Do you realize how hard it is to draw everything in the correct perspective and correct proportions? It's easy to fuck up. The hand could be too big or Juice WRLD's head could be too small compared to her head. You know, there's so many things that can go wrong. So mad props for someone who can do it straight from the rip, like off the top of the dome, you know?
And I found it.
Fire. Hold up. I'm gonna listen to that whole part again. I don't listen to Halsey. I still feel like I'm saying it wrong, but I'm probably not. But if I am, let me know. But I don't listen to her work. But after hearing his voice right now, I might have to. Cause that's.
Thank God I finally found you. You put the light in my eyes when I'm around you. I'm too flawed.
She said, "Thank God I finally found you. You put the light in my eyes when I'm around you." Oh man, that's a bar. I was dead inside until you came around and put that sparkle in there. Being in love, like if you were ever in love or if you've had like deep love connection before, even if you don't now, you know that feeling.
Put the light in my eyes when I'm around you. I'm too flawed to hold you down.
I'm too flawed to hold you down, but I don't want to be here alone. God damn. And that's like the direct sentiment that Juice WRLD was saying in the hook, but she's saying it in a different way. Like I was too flawed until I finally found you. Like I felt like I wasn't good enough for anybody, but you made me feel like I was good enough for you. And that's exactly what Juice WRLD said in a different way. He said, you accepted me and then you set me free. Like you accepted me for who I was, flaws and all, no Beyonce. That set me free. That set my soul free. It's fire.
Found you. I'll put the light in your eyes if I'm allowed to.
Yeah. See what I mean? Like, life's a mess, but it's a beautiful mess. Whenever you find the one, whenever you find your soulmate, the person that you're compatible with. Yeah. That shit was like so good, bro. This right here, Juice WRLD, this sounds like Juice WRLD. And that gives me like a glimmer of hope for what the album's gonna be on Friday. Yeah. RIP Juice, man. The dude was just a talent, like a one of a kind artist. And there's probably no one that will ever fill that unique lane that he created because it's Juice WRLD, you know? But yo, that's the end of today's video, ladies and gentlemen. If you like what you see, please consider liking the video and leaving a comment down below. Helps the algorithm catch the video and send it out there to other people in the recommended section. Hey, this video is getting a lot of activity. Maybe other people will want to watch it, and maybe we could put more ads in front of their fucking face, and then they can buy product from our advertisers, and then we profit. That's how the algorithm works, by the way. But if you like what you see enough, and you like the analytical feedback and the breakdown of what I'm seeing versus what I'm hearing and the lyrics and all of that shit, consider subscribing, because that's how we do it around here. Follow your boy on Instagram and on Twitter at @TheThirdErnest, just like the channel. Links are down in the description below. Hit up the Discord, also link down in the description below. Check out my boy's clothing line, also link down in the description below. But that's it for today, and like I always say at the very end of all of my videos, go out there in the world, love and care for one another, love and care for each other, and I'll catch everybody on the next video. Peace.